Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 20 of the hard mode playthrough of Railroader. Now, last episode we did things a little differently. Well, not necessarily like in a day, but so I ended the episode at a different point than normal. So for today's episode, we're going to be taking number two back to the engine shed at Dillsboro, and we're going to be running number one with the empty pulpwood cars whenever they become empty to get loaded up. So yeah, I'm not sure how long this episode's gonna last. First time I'm trying it, so yeah, let's get to work. Oh yeah. Gotta get rid of the handbrake. There we go. And I gotta pull up the map. All right. Right, so now we'll go to number one. Oh man, I closed the wrong thing. Right, so the weather now is going to be clear. And I can wait one more hour. Maybe one more. Still not done? Is it full? This one's got to be full then. Let's check that. Yep, 100%, 73. Okay, well, that's good. So I'll just force this to cycle. There we go. Yeah, well, there's another reason not to listen to Diddy. In hindsight. So yeah, we're gonna have him go back. Morning. There we go. Should be good now. You know, I'm thinking the way I should do this is having like a separate set of six. Full ones go here, the empties go, you know, like changing back and forth. I think that's going to be the best way to do this because the pulpwood takes so long to load. Plus, it seems like 6 kind of pushes us a little hard at that 1% grade. Number 2 must be approaching. Yep. Okay, so switch him to 15. Get rid of that. Actually, probably 10. What's wrong with the long black train? Yeah, did I switch back? Yes. I wonder if I change my draw distance to max, if that'll help out. Gonna try some okay. I just want to see what would happen with that. If I bump that down to 1.5. Doing graphic setting stuff in the middle of the video. Because why not? I mean, you guys should see what I do. Instead of just, you know, having me doing the settings off video and my offline save, and then just showing up with it looking different. At least now you can see, like, what I did differently. It's actually a mod. It actually seems to be working pretty good. I wonder what happens if I bump this up. Yeah, that was a big difference. This seems to be like the best running so far. I don't know why the trees are doing that weird shit. It's like they're changing color or something. Spawning in. How's that gonna do? Oh yeah, we're almost to our first drop off. Oh man. I am so sorry for it deleting your. I didn't know it was gonna delete your message. Thank you so much for the raid. Oh man, that's embarrassing. Oh man. All right, hold on. We're pausing. We're pausing, making a I wasn't paying attention because I was trying to make sure that everything that could and should be turned off was turned off as far as like the filter protections. For all the new people that are still here, thank you for joining me tonight. Thank you very much. I appreciate you hanging out with me, even though it's just a short little time. I still appreciate it, and I hope you have a wonderful night. And let's speed this train up. And hopefully next time I get a raid, it don't delete their emote spam along with it and make me look silly like I just did. I apologize to everyone. I'm so sorry. I just realized it timed you out. Oh my gosh. This is even worse than I thought. Oh my gosh. Did it time anyone else out? Oh man, this is so embarrassing. Now it's like stuck there. Now I can't see it. Oh my gosh. There we go. It's working. Yay. Emotes are working. There we go. If I think the title is pretty accurate, things will be damaged and cars will be derailed and messages and raids will be deleted. Okay, thank you so much for chatting with me tonight. I appreciate it. Good night. It might have been 'cause like I didn't unban you until I actually like started talking about it, or not unban, but untimed you out. So it might have been because you were timed out. Ah, there it goes. Thank you. All right. Well, thank you so much for the raid. I really appreciate it. I'm sorry about it deleting your emotes, but at least it taught me an important lesson. But hope you have a wonderful night. Hope you have a good day tomorrow, and hopefully I see you later. Yes, it's an incredible game. I got it March 1st, and I already have like over 300 hours into it. I just love it. I'm addicted. It's almost unhealthy. Didn't realize that's gonna make me zoom in game. That's funny. All right, we are almost to, oh yeah, I should check on the luck cards while I'm here. Zoom ahead and do that. Well, seeing as... Might as well bring him up there. I don't see the point of just going up there and coming back down and going back up there and coming back down. Seems silly. Actually, yeah, I don't know why I brought that one. Oh well. It don't really matter at this point.
Thank you.
almost went down the wrong track. I caught that at the last second. I don't know if I should just stay up here and wait for the night, or if I should hook back up to the log one, bring that down, and then come back up for the morning. I don't know, seeing as how the sawmill's full, I don't see why I would need to do it tonight or today in game. So yeah, I think I'm just gonna hook back up to the log train and then call it there and then see how long it is and see if I can call it a full episode. Okay. Well, guys, that will do it for this episode, possibly. I want to thank you for watching. If you've left a like, comment, or subscribed on YouTube, if you chatted in Twitch, followed in Twitch, just anything that you have supported me in any way, I truly appreciate it, and I'll catch you all in the next episode.